Good morning. So let's continue with the chapter. Chapter 1, Book B, Challenges of Nation Building. And we were discussing the demarcating the boundaries of the state in Indian territory on the basis of language. As I told you in my previous lecture, initially when we were struggling for independence, it was promised by our leaders, freedom fighters, that when India becomes independent, states would be, the boundaries will be made on the basis of language. But since we had a traumatic experience of how Pakistan was carved out of India, and there was a question of the future of princely states, for some time central leadership postponed this matter. But it could not be taken up the way it was expected, and there was very staunch and very strong demand, especially by this Vishal Andhra movement. Vishal Andhra movement, it was a movement which paved a way, which decided that how is it so that the boundaries of the state should be made on the basis of language and culture. It happened so that Vishal Andhra movement was the movement which demanded that Telugu speaking people should be having a separate state. They demanded for Andhra Pradesh out of Madras state. This old Madras state, it comprised of Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, Kerala and some parts of Andhra Pradesh, I must say. And Kannada speaking people, Malayali speaking people, Tamil speaking people, they all lived together in this old Madras state, Madras province, which Britishers had done for their own administrative convenience. But now when we became independent, there was severe, very strong movement that Telugu speaking people should be having their own separate state, and they started demanding Andhra Pradesh. Initially the Indian government tried to control the movement, tried to console the situation and all, but it was not successful. And finally in 1952, on December 1952, Andhra Pradesh was made out of Madras state. So Andhra Pradesh, remember students, Andhra Pradesh was the first state in India which was made on the basis of language. It was given to Telugu speaking people. Now this demand, when Andhra Pradesh came into being, this demand, it started coming from different regions, from different areas of Indian territory, that the state should be having boundaries on the basis of language and cultural differences, especially language. And that is the reason the central government, in 1953, State Reorganization Commission came into being. State Reorganization Commission was made to submit a report. What about? To submit a report about that whether it was required that the state should be made, the boundaries of the state should be carved out, should be demarcated on the basis of language. And in 1956, State Reorganization Commission, on the basis of the report of State Reorganization Commission, in 1956, State Reorganization Act was passed, and the basis of that act was to demarcate, to decide the boundaries of the different states on Indian territory on the basis of language. As a result of that, 14 states and 6 union territories came into existence. We must remember, in 1956, State Reorganization Act was passed. As a result of that, 14 states and 6 union territories came into existence, and Andhra Pradesh was the first state which came into being on the basis of language in December 1952. Now the biggest question which comes into mind, that how is it so that Pakistan was also made as a result of two nation theory, and then now state, different boundaries of the states, they were carved out on the basis of language, linguistic and cultural differences. Did it affect the unity of the country? But no, rather it affected positively the democratic nature of the country. Rather, as a result, when states were given separate boundaries on the basis of language, rather it opened new horizons for Indian politics. No more the Indian politics was the privilege of some English speaking elite class people. Rather, more and more local people could participate in politics, because now more and more language, like, you know, local languages were spoken while discussing political matters. And rather, when more autonomy was given to different people, when they had this feeling that they are not suppressed by, like, you know, majority, or I must say that their autonomy or their linguistic and cultural individuality was taken care of, then it led to the unity of the country in a better manner, and it strengthened the political attitude, the democratic attitude of Indian politics. And this is how the chapter comes to an end. And in my next lecture, we will be discussing the question answers of this chapter. Thank you.